poop, then find out.
That works. As they move from Queensland to Tasmania, the Royal Tour is going from strength to strength. And whilst it's been a great personal victory for Prince Charles, no one can deny it's the Princess of Wales who's truly captured the heart of a nation.
Well, she's not stuffy like the rest of the world.
Right.
You get a sense of her being a real person.
Yes.
You've got to love her, haven't you?
Do you love Charles as much as you love Diana?
Yeah, she loves him. He must have something, mustn't he?
She's so
and what do you think of the princess?
She's amazing.
She's
just like
her. Is she? Yeah. You think you could have a cup of tea with her?
Absolutely. She's really down to earth, that fine.
It's a great pleasure to be able to come to Tasmania to receive such an enthusiastic and heartwarming welcome. The last time I was here was 2 years ago, 1981, shortly before we were married. At that time, everybody was saying good luck and hope everything goes well, and how lucky you are to be engaged to such a lovely lady. And my goodness, I am lucky enough to be married to her. That's the thing about ladies, you never quite know what they get up to when your back's turned. The final straw, honestly. Putting faces, horsing around while I'm trying to do my job.
I was blushing at your compliments.
The people were laughing at me, laughing in my face at the end of a week in which half of Australia has also been booing me. I don't deserve this. This is supposed to be my tour. My tour as Prince of Wales to shore up one of the key countries in the Commonwealth at a very delicate moment politically, and thanks to you...
Thanks to me, people have shown up. Thanks to me, people are interested.
No, thanks to you, people are laughing in my face. Booing the heir to the throne, booing the crown.
Oh, come on. Oh, don't do this.